Hello and welcome, Tori here, and today we're gonna be watching the more consistent quality. Is that true? Damn, should I really watch it on YouTube? You know what? We're watching it on YouTube. We'll be weird today. Why not? Are they behind? Alright, never mind. We'll watch it now. Okay, ready? Alright, we're going to YouTube then. Me too, Penelope. I'm very excited. Alright. 3, 2, 1. Action. Hello and welcome. It's Tori here. And today we're going to be watching the 5.0 Genshin livestream. I'm very excited. We've been waiting all day for this, obviously. They changed the time zone for it, which I'm so excited that it's not releasing right in the morning, right before I have to go to work. We're going to watch it. Hopefully they give us some fun and exciting stuff about Natlan. And yeah, right now they're playing... Hold on, where are we? They're playing Dino. Whatever this is. The music is a vibe. Oh yeah, you guys can all say hi to YouTube in the corner. It is kind of like Flappy Bird. Or it's like that one, like when the internet's off on Google. Do you know what game I'm talking about? Yeah, this is actually, this is not long. This is it. So that's all you get. Hope you like Flappy Bird. No, I'm kidding. Ajax, is that his name? Oh, right. Yes. Never mind. They literally said that in that big trailer they had. Honestly, is it? Oh, Ajaw? Oh, Ajax is Tartaglia. Right? It's Ajaw. Everyone's saying Ajax. Penelope, funny enough, you said that on TikTok. Two other people on Twitch said that too. So you're not alone. And then I said it. Maybe I just missed Tartaglia, guys. Maybe I just missed Child being in jail in Fontaine. Like, you don't know that, you know? It was just, was it Freudian slip? He was just on my mind. Always. No, I'm kidding. Very excited. The music is so vibey. It's so, the YouTube one's actually behind Twitch, I'm not gonna lie. I looked because the YouTube one was at 16. Oh. Stage clear. The quality's better. That's fine. I'm not upset about this. Ooh.
We've arrived at the final phase. The winner of this
How's the volume?
Will take the final spot among the victors.
Given Why is,
for
what?
A long time contending. And first time finalist.
From this point forward,
why are the captions in German?
The real world no longer applies. Anything can happen here. There's something in the depths of this place that feels familiar, yet also foreign.
The pilgrimage is not merely to determine the strongest among us,
Sorry.
But also a stage upon which to showcase your individual growth.
Ooh.
The purpose of the pilgrimage is not only to select strong warriors, but also to collect contending fire from the battles. Natlan is only safe from the invasion of the abyss, while the sacred flame burns eternal.
See, Kinnick looks really cool. I'm sorry. Am I seeing swapping animations?
Guess I'll have to wait until the next pilgrimage.
Aw.
I'm still not sure why Arwayup chose me of all people.
It took the combined efforts of the then Pyro Archon and heroes from every tribe to finally repel the abyss.
Dragons!
Even so, the abyss lingered for hundreds of years. Able to be reversed little by little.
Our current Archon achieved it over.
Look at those. It's giving arc.
The result was obvious from the beginning. I really want to win this time and become a true warrior.
But through our long history of fighting the Abyss, we've realized things aren't quite so simple. The Abyss has invaded the Night Kingdom.
There we go.
And has the capacity to read the
I don't know why it was in German.
At any given moment.
Going there, the Night Kingdom? Only those who triumph over the Abyss earn the right to be revived. Defeat not only means death, but also the destruction of your ancient name, preventing it from ever being inherited again.
You heard something from here, didn't you?
K'neech, what is the meaning of this?
K'neech!
Only one way to awaken you all from your willful blindness. More sacrifices must be made.
You'll die if you try to make your way forward. Why don't you just give up?
You want to know why I won't give up?
I should have died 5 years ago.
Take me as your next sacrifice!
Natlan is on the verge of destruction. It's very possible our nation has less than a year before total devastation.
Lava!
Once your ancient name disappears, there's no coming back.
No!
The music!
Where can I find him? Why?
Every great display of power comes at a price.
That is the tragedy of your short lives. You understand nothing of all-encompassing power.
You shall unite the tribes and save Natlan from its impending doom.
What use is the Gnosis in your hands?
Here he comes.
I don't know what you mean, but it sounds like this is about more than the Tsaritsa.
Your plan has reached an impasse,
and Genshin
now it falls
impact.
To me to create new rules for Natlan.
Ooh, Cryo Sword?
Like let our blade do the talking!
Her hair! Her hair was on fire, you're lying. You're lying. She looks so good. Oh. Okay.
这次远程前站有些特殊任务需要我亲自完成，我去找项目同学问一下。
It's Dawei. Hey, buddy. Oh, the shirt with the little buddy on it is so cute. Give me one. Toy over. Hand it over. Give me the shirt.
看来大家对娜塔还是有很多期待和疑问嘛。那我们也不能辜负大家的期待啊。让我们先看今天项目的图片怎么说。
Should I lift my camera up so you guys can see the captions? Would you guys prefer that if I lifted it up a little bit? Like this?
准备怎么样啊?
挺好的。
Yeah, that's better.
准备领原石。好。Right
here.
各位女性们，大家好，欢迎来到《原神5.0》前瞻特别节目。我是你们老朋友大伟哥。那么今天呢，我们又请到了我们的项目组老朋友啊，战斗设计师鸡哥，IP负责人小罗浩。Hello，
大家好，我是大家的老朋友鸡哥。那这一次来到5.0的前瞻节目呢，也是要跟大家去分享一下我们在新的版本，也就是纳塔这片区域上的游戏内容的一些设计思路和理念。大家好，我是你们的老朋友小罗浩。那个，
Here we go，sorry，还是。
由我来，在这个1.1度的这个大版本啊，就是和大家分享一些我们纳塔的世界观和角色相关的一些信息和情报。哎，欢迎我们的小朋友老罗浩和鸡哥来到我们的前瞻特别节目啊！哎，那么我们今天啊的这个前瞻节目跟以往有点不一样啊，肯定要给大家一些小小的挑战。
啊啊！挑战
？They'll have different shirts.
挑战吗？对的，那个发源石吗？哎，那大家别紧张啊！哎，之前我们不是做过一轮那个问卷调查吗？没错，大家其实对我们那个纳塔其实都是非常非常感兴趣的。那么今天啊，我们也是专门把这些问题抽出来，请你们两位现场来跟大家。
So sorry, guys. I'm like in the way.
现场答吗？就没有稿子吗？
肯定是大家都很熟悉的问题啊。
I can't.
那么，要不先
I can't block my friend Dawei.
试试呗。
Bring it on.
那我们开始第一轮挑战啊。那我看一下，我们第一个问题啊，好像是比较特殊的。
问题还有特殊问题吗？让我们来看
VCR。
在4.0版本的前瞻直播当中呢，项目组有提到过，每年都会推出一个新的玩法。Who
is this？
这次就是新的大世界移动体系。那选择它作为原神纳塔版本新玩法的原因是什么呢？ 在制作的过程当中有解决什么技术上的难题。
Who is this hero? I love him.
这个人这么熟悉一点，因为刚好我也是战斗设计师，这部分刚好也是我的专业领域嘛。我先说一个比较大的概念啊，就是原神它其实是一个开放世界游戏，当然这个大家都知道，对吧？但在我们的理解里面，其实开放设计游戏它更关注的两条，一个是关于玩家交互行为本身，以及交互行为带来的反馈。对，那其实大家也都知道，就是在原神的过往的版本里面，其实我们一直有一个叫元素的概念。那元素这个概念本身呢，也是交互反馈的一种体现。就比如说我去拿火元素打一下冰雾花，这冰雾花可能就变成一个可以采集的状态，对吧？那交互的反馈在这么多的版本里面已经获得了非常充分的体现。
对，
那这次我们想换一个思路，我们想在交互的形式上去做一些花样。尤其是其实玩家其实更关注我们的角色能做哪些事情。对，因为原本我们会发现在比如说1.6 的版本，我们有一个
Wave Rider
玩法叫浪船
啊，对
吧？然后在3.6版本我们做了一个叫花灵的这样的一个族群，那么他们有一位叫斯路莎的勇者，对吧？那他其实也会有一些独特的移动方式。那到了5.0，我们其实想做一个尝试，就是把这些东西全都呈现在角色自己的行为模式。
They are just chitty chat. I appreciate this yapping. 4.8
和4.7这两个版本的彩蛋里面也看到了一些端倪，就是包括我们展出的这三位角色，他们都会有各自不同的行动
方
式。
啊，我理解了，就是说我们是角色的这个移动能力是不是要得到空前的这个变化？
对，其实你看，就是之前我也看到过有旅行者在社区里面有说到，那这次我们是不是可以有一些飞檐走壁的
parkour
的行为模式嘛？那大家也都在视频当中也有看到，我们确实是在做这样的尝试。
哎，我看到还有玩家问到啊，说那个前瞻彩蛋里面那个马纳尼踩的那个滑板，它到底是个道具啊，还是个技能？
其实我觉得就是硬要说的话，它其实是算技能。
Skill, OK。
但是我觉得呢，就像刚才我说的一样，其实这些新角色的行为模式是融入到它的方方面面的。就它作为一个技能来说，可能有点狭隘吧。然后第二条其实是如果把它作为道具的话呢，感觉有点。
他应该是伙伴才对，
对，应该是伙伴。
这个我感觉我已经感受到了。那么我们问完这个第一个问题，我感觉这个还可以啊，这个还可以，游刃有余啊。那我们再看看是不是要提供一点更难的问题啊？
还有更难的吗？
又是一个彩蛋掉落啊！让我们来看。
I will say when the Wave Rider was introduced, a lot of people thought it wasn't going to be permanent, which is very funny. 今
回は原神チームにバージョン 5.0 に関する
質問を
してみたいと思います。ナタ初報 PV で数種類のドラゴンが公開されましたが、あの力を借りてどうすることができるんでしょうか。PV の最後にね飛んでいくドラゴンいましたけど、あんな感じで。
Give me one. Where do I get it?
それとナタのキャラクターって独自の探索システムとかは持っているんでしょうか。よければたっぷり教えてください。
也是一位我们的老朋友。
这一位其实我也看过，好像是叫
金枪鱼头。
对，金枪鱼头，对对对。
凯亚系列攻略我很喜欢。
对，包括七人召唤他也特别喜欢凯亚。
对对对，是。
OK。那其实他刚才也有提到说龙的探索机制是如何设计的。他提到说在我们 PV 的末尾是有一个飞行的龙。
Insane amounts of drip in this trailer.
透
今天是干货，
那其实就是包括
这条飞行的龙内啊，
纳塔所有的
玩
家看到的这种不同形态的龙，他们各自都会有一套独特的探索机制。那这个探索机制呢，和刚才这个问题里面我们提及的包括纳塔的角色他们之间也会有一些息息相关的设计点。大家肯定会有疑问说，之前在视频里看到说我们好像可以操作这些龙进行探索，那到底是我们通过某种方式驯化了
Do you tame them like in the hit game Ark?
把自己
like an Ark?
这个龙的体内怎么样，对吧？那其实我想说的是，我们其实提供了一种类似
indwelling mechanic
附身的这样的一个机制。
附身，
对，可以让旅行者在纳塔的领域区域内，去通过附身的这样一个机制去获得这些龙的操作权。
Okay, so you like become them, you don't like ride them.
精通不同的探索的一些本领。
对对对，我感觉这个意思说
very cute. 到
纳塔之后啊，我们是可以真飞檐走壁，对吧？
对，没错。那还是回归到刚才金枪鱼头提到的那个问题啊，就是我们会不会有飞行的可能？
Stop! Don't be weird, you two.
大家可以尽情期待纳塔后续的版本里面，我们给大家提供的内容。我感觉前面两个问题都是鸡哥，我一定要抽一个，别小罗号，不能让小罗号闲着啊！我们在做问卷调查的时候，就想说三成的玩家提到我们整个纳塔的这个世界观，就是大家都想了解，比如说纳塔的这个设计、这个灵感是从哪里来呀？包括说我们在纳塔里面非常重要，有很多龙嘛，包括觉得纳塔也是一个这种人龙。
共生的这么一个国家，所以想起小罗号，这个纳塔啊，我们这个人和龙之间是什么样的这个共生关系啊？我们知道就是纳塔的部族当中，龙啊被纳塔人视为自己的家族成员。对，说一个可能不是很恰当的比喻，有点像我们养。 猫猫狗狗
，Sorry, these are so
cute。其实就是纳塔人，那我还是愿意养龙的。有机会，但我也很想，他们在一起生活，在一起工作战斗，彼此信任呢，也彼此照顾。虽然纳塔的人和龙伙伴之间可能没有办法直接用语言相通，但是长久的相处呢，也能够让他们能够弄懂彼此的心思和一些就是习惯了。
对。
那么我们旅行者在拜访各个不同部族的时候呢，就可以发现纳塔人和龙伙伴相处的方式。 可能也会有些不一样，就比如说在我们应该第一个接触的部落，浑身之子中稳重可靠的疾风龙伙伴呢，会帮助他们的部族成员挖掘宝藏，Petalosaurus，Petalosaurus，去开辟通路。
哇，这个很有用，感觉。
I'm telling you, those little guys, they remind me of the moles in Avatar, the ones that taught Earthbending.
人类伙伴的照顾了。
That's what they remind me of, because they are kind of mole-like, but still.
我们会接触到这三个部族的龙伙伴。
I love them.
然后在之后的环节当中。
我们会有专门的episode，那这里我就先详细的演绎。对，就接下来的环节我们还会有更多相关信息的爆料给大家提供。对对对对对，我听完小王的介绍，Earth Power very cool。纳塔人和龙是一种非常和谐共生啊，而且是非常友爱的这样一种氛围啊，我觉得非常非常期待啊。The best friends。那么我们接下来看这个第三题，那第三题呢也是个特殊问题，我们来看VCR。
我们看这次又是哪位大佬？Well, look who it is!
I'm Tuanto, and I'm here to ask some questions for the Genshin team regarding
5.0. It's Tuanto.
Pyro's the spotlighted element for the new update, specifically for Natlin. And I'm curious, how does Pyro have a significance in Natlin? Will Natlin be more accessible for newer players in the game? Because I do know that a lot of newer players have difficulties and or struggle to get to the newer pieces of content that get added to the game. Honestly, it is insane that we are at Natlin now. I want
Agreed.
To give you guys all my luck, because if I can't win the 50-50, I hope at the very least you can. And I hope you find your own true meaning on your own journey. In Genshin Impact.
Wait, whoa, 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 wait, why are we getting, I'm gonna get upset. Don't, why are we getting sentimental? Hold on, hold on.
Whoa. 那火在纳塔呢，有着独一无二的实用的意义。 除了我们普通的那种火之外，纳塔还存在着广泛存在着一种名为燃素的。
Let's not get too sentimental, I'm a very emotional person. I'll start crying.
每种呢都有很独特的妙用，这一点呢，我觉得旅行者一进纳塔探索就能自己亲身体验到了。
那在纳塔其实大家可以把燃素认知为一种，纳塔独有的高阶的能源火元素的呈现形式啊，它有时候可能是能源，有的时候又可能作为一种战斗当中的策略资源。那当然除了战斗方面的价值和能力，它本身也有很重要的精神层面的一些意义。火就是纳塔的精神图腾嘛，对，就像我们纳塔的最核心的建筑物地标圣火竞技场，
没错，
里面
有
昂扬古墓那个圣火。
火就象征着纳塔人们，他们有不屈服的一种精神。然后纳塔历代有很多英雄和英杰，他们用自己的精神和力量，将纳塔的火不断的向未来、向新一代去传递。无论他们遇见了怎样的艰难和挑战，他们的火都不会熄灭。
我们一直知道那个纳塔被称为是这个战争的这个国度啊，那么其中这个战争的含义是什么呢？
之所以说纳塔是战争的国度，是因为纳塔在历史上曾经面临过无数场。 危机，那么为了保护自己的家园，我们之前也提到纳塔的人民，还有纳塔的龙，他们一起并力同心抵御着各种侵害纳塔的势力。那么在一场又一场这样的战斗中，涌现出了无数的英雄。那他们在这种战斗和战争中留下的英勇事迹呢？
This is very accurate to Latin America.
在历史上刻写成为古名，古名也是我们纳塔的一个比较核心的一个人文概念。然后以此将英雄们的事迹和精神传承下去。 那么一代又一代的纳塔人呢，在古民的引导下，不断的成长，不断的去战斗，和过去那些他们历史上的英雄们一样，用自己的力量支撑着纳塔。 在
I don't mind, guys. This is enjoy the yapping. This is good yap. This is good combos.
到了如今呢，六大公主之间依然会彼此竞争，在圣火竞技场所举办的大赛中比拼各项的能力，从而选拔出最为强大的战士。
You guys should have got a coffee like me. Have a nice Americano to sip on.
对，所以这次娜塔的这个战争并不是我们理解的那个战争，是而是竞技，对吧？
其实
no, you can't, Darcy.
既包含了竞技，也包含了
not on my stream. This is not a free country right here. On my stream.
战斗，但是呢，通过竞技
oh, it's on what's your face. Oh, it's everyone. Okay, everyone's here.
势力去进行对抗，他们又如何看待就是他们身处的战争？那就
I don't really like her. What's her name? The girl with the elf ears. She's kind of
主线剧情中去切身体验了。
Not on my face.
几乎有这个五成的这个问卷啊，都提到了这个火神啊。相信那个旅行者们啊都很好奇，说火神是有什么样的性格。那旅行者呢，在娜塔又会跟火神一同经历怎样的故事？
Yes, her.
火神嘛，我们
I thought she was pretty, but then I looked at her closer and I was like, ooh,
说娜塔是战士里面的最强人、最强者。那火神率领的娜塔战士们迎接了无数的战争，也夺得了无数的胜利。无论面对怎样的敌人，火神的火焰从来没有暗淡过半分。嗯，就是对于
That's my girl right there. Love her.
只要跟随着火神，他们就可以战胜任何胆敢侵犯娜塔的敌人。他就像是一轮永不落下的太阳，在他的照耀之下，所有的迷茫和不安都会被驱除。那么当我们的旅行者啊到我们的娜塔和火神马维卡相遇的时候，在和他一起上战场，想必也会一定会体会到马维卡的热情，感受到他的光芒和温度。那至于他的性格，我觉得大家很快就能够体会到他所拥有的那种和他的力量相匹配的那种
王者一样的自信了。
对对，我印象特别深刻。我看我们娜塔前段短片的时候啊，看到
Oh my God, she's up so pretty.
充满了这个自信啊！
对对对，
前面聊了这么多啊，我看我们还有两个特别有意思的问题啊，那也请两位来一起来看看。
I remember people originally speculated.
오늘은 원신 팀에게 5.0 버전과 관련된 몇 가지 질문을 드릴 건데요.
Okay, we ask question.
나타는 발전 형상을 보면 부활과 관련된 뭔가.
The whole resurrection thing, I'm intrigued about that.
혹시 원신 세간에 이미 죽은 누군가가 부활하다는 뜻 아니겠죠? 아 그리고 우인다 집중한 카피타노 두꺼운 톡으로 쓰고 있는데 설마 나타의 무더운 날씨에 기절해버리는 건 아닐까 싶습니다
Heat stroke is crazy
看看谁来回答
Well he has a cryo sword so he keeps himself cool I imagine
说到
Guys what if what's her face comes back
我可能说得远一些就是战争的国度嘛它必然会伴随着牺牲那死亡从来都无法被轻易逆转但是呢在娜塔唯独在娜塔就是我们英雄们的火焰不太会轻易的熄灭就我们足迹疲语里面说到戴英说过一句谜语嘛就败者成为战火的余烬而胜者重燃
对
那在娜塔牺牲是无法阻拦英雄们奋战的脚步的他们是有机会去继续战斗直到那一场战争彻底的终结
They're gonna revive the dragon Durin?
是怎样的一个重燃的这个机制？不要卖一个关子，因为这个就是我们娜塔的剧情里面一个很核心体验的一个部分。
就那大哥，你知道，就每次到这种时候，我其实是憋得最难受的那一个。
那你是他队长吧？
行，OK， 就是那队长，其实在娜塔的整个主线剧情当中也扮演了一个非常重要的角色。对，那刚才小罗浩所说到的重燃，包括战争这些概念，某种意义上也是队长来到这片。土地的原因，对对，那刚才
Yeah, they give him a second chance.
至于说刚才那个奇妙的问题
Whoa, Aquarius spilling too much tea, y'all. Someone get better.
那我可能再剧透一下
Yes.
可能由于某种原因，我觉得他不太可能会中暑。
哦，我感觉我已经 get 到一些信息了啊。
We saw the cryo sword. You can't fool us.
火神与队长啊。
Aquarius is so real for that. Shout out him for.
是不是也该登场了
？Spoiling.
哦，对哦。
That's my friend right there. Love you.
对，
不过在此之前啊，我们先看一段短片。
Oh, hey, girlie. Oh, her outfit's so cute. How cute!Music is so bubbly. She's so cute. I love how cheery she is and whatnot. Oh, I love her outfit too. Who's styling these girls? They look great. me rolling around in my chair at work. That little one, Kachina, she's so freaking cute. Oh, that's unfortunate. Go on. She said, go get it. What are older brothers for? Come on. Ooh, his movement is so cool. Wait. An Ajaw, not Ajax. Ajaw. Oh, guys, first code 2SMTYV59TLFD. Thank you, Darcy, for pinning that. I'm gonna copy and paste it and post it on TikTok for you guys. There you go, that's the code, the first code. Copy and paste that, redeem that in Genshin for 100 primos. This music survived. The music's been, Genshin always, Hoyoverse does such a good job with the music, I can't even complain, really. Darcy, do you think when this is done, you can make two highlights, one of just the trailer reaction and then one of the whole thing? Welcome back, travelers.
Thank you, Darcy.
New characters and new stories.
Let me correct my posture too.
He has tea and everything. I love him.
So it's another geo construct.
That's good to know, I guess, for Chiori havers, right?
那在这个领域里面呢，其实冲天转转也会获得一些强化的能力。除了这些战斗的技巧以外，那卡奇娜当然她作为部族的勇士，也有一些当地人的从容。那么她熟悉大塔的当地区域，也就是说，
哦，she helps you find the regional specialties. Good to know.
在旅行者的小地图上显示纳塔区域特展的位置。哦，特产雷达。而且它在去和纳塔的一部分采集物交互的时候呢，还会去恢复全队的体力。这算是四星角色里面，它就特别能够帮助我们去进行大世界探索的一个好帮手了。
女性哦，我听到了，so cute。就是荣花与炎日之徒这样一个陌生任务当中，哦，we get her。随后不久就会遇到卡奇娜，那随后她就会很自然的加入到主角的冒险队伍当中了。那我们说了这么多，卡奇娜的这位同伴就是来自流泉部落的穆拉阿尼，穆拉阿尼，卡奇娜她自己，I kept butchering that earlier，I was having a hard time pronouncing that。世界上有这么好的人，还有这么多好玩的事情。 那作为流泉之众的成员呢，马拉妮她酷爱各类水上运动，比如说游泳、跳水、冲浪，还有沙滩排球。但比起自己玩的开心，她更享受和大家一起度过美妙的时光。无论是她作为水上用品商店的店主呢，还是她作为一个新生代的向导当中的一个佼佼者呀，马拉妮她都非常热心于和他人推荐一段 充满乐趣和惊喜的旅程。那么在部族祭文流泉之众当中呢，旅行者就有机会和马拉尼一起踏上一场探寻传说中啊神秘岛屿的一个旅程。那相信成为童话五国的旅行者一定不会错过这样的冒险和挑战，因为他也是流泉之众的勇士。那么他在战斗当中也会
Hydro Traveler, not Pyro Traveler.
首先大家也可以看到马拉尼是一位使用水元素的 法器角色，哦，法器角色，对，它是一位法器角色。那会搭一个叫沙沙冲浪板的这样一个水上用品来提升自己在地面和水面上的这样一个行动能力。那马拉尼本身是一个攻击节奏可能不那么快的角色，但是因为他很灵活，他可以利用自己的身法为自己接下来发动的这次攻击去积攒一些优势。所以他在移动当中呢，这个沙沙冲浪板可以标记并且撕咬敌人。这个撕咬可能本身并没有
产生一些很强的。I can see myself hating this, though, like for me using her, can you imagine me, my skill issues, I'd just be sliding around the map, like I would get lost, I would run away from enemies on accident, I'd be such a fool. My stupid self, yeah, that'd be interesting. I just slide all over the place. It'd be like when I use a lawn skill and I just miss.
She can show the location of the minimap. Okay. That
little current thing reminds me specifically of Sonic Riders. I don't know if y'all know that game. It's an older game.
Vaguely reminded me of that.
So his like tribe is very, very strong. They're like District 1 of the Hunger Games.
<笑>有什么独家秘诀？比如说我注意到基尼奇好像不是，有个很奇怪的，算是生物吗？有个很奇怪的龙伙伴。对，那个这个伙伴是为他在战斗中会提供不小的助力，那他有没有什么来头呢？那这位自称伟大圣龙的库胡勒阿乔，我们大家都称呼他阿乔吧，和基尼奇是几乎形影不离的。
阿乔，我感觉他的画风跟其他人不太一样啊。<笑> 那么这样的龙伙伴确实也会为基尼奇他自己招致的一些非议，但好像来说就是基尼奇也不是很在意，就是他并不屑于靠语言来为自己辩白，他总是一个怎么说呢，意志很坚定，目标很清晰，
Silent but deadly type，
就是完成自己的委托，然后去向委托人去收取他认为合适的报酬。 而更多关于纪尼奇还有玄牧人的过去以及他所继承的古名的秘文呢，旅行者们都可以通过我们的部族纪文玄牧人的任务
，my bad, my bad, my bad, my bad
的解答。
那同样也轮到我来介绍一下纪尼奇的战斗技能了。那大家也看到了，他是一个擅长极限运动的这样的一个少年，所以在战斗当中他也会用类似的。
I love his movement. I'm obsessed with this. I'm sorry, I'm pulling. I have to get him.
除此以外，他的
Also, I can see myself being bad at using this too, so maybe not.
并且在合适的时机，他会发射一种。
I have to try it out.
很厉害的像
Character trials will be a must for me in this region, it looks like. But he looks very fun, yeah.
感觉是个很中二的名字。对，他瞄准了敌人发出强力的一击，而他释放元素爆发的时候呢，在他身边这个
好像是一个很热
的圣龙阿乔就会解放自己的力量，释放吐息来摧毁眼前的敌人。
I love that.
和其他两位勇士一样。
I love that.
你大概会猜到基尼奇在纳塔的大地上
也会具备什么样的能力。The dragon in the sky? That's so cool.
太好了。
I love that a lot.
我们 5.0 的这三位伙伴都能够帮助我们去收集纳塔的特产。
没错，因为基尼奇他也有显示纳塔区域特产的能力，并且除此之外，他也有作为玄牧人部族成员的能力，也就是他和部分的采集物交互的时候，还可以去提升队伍中所有角色的移动速度。
我已经就预见到，就他能够很快加入玩家的队伍。
Oh, that's funny. You get items and you get a speed buff. That's interesting. It's like when you use Baiju, if you pick up the like certain things, you get healed. That's interesting. Ow, yeah. And then speed boost.
然后我们把这种机制和纳塔本土的一些世界观结合起来。称呼之为夜魂加持。
纳
塔的角色会利用这种叫夜魂加持的状态，在战斗中充分。
1000 aura points。
这种能力，我就接过话茬，是通过我们被称为一种叫做燃素刻录的仪式来激发的。借助这种古老的仪式啊，在纳塔地区，神之眼的持有者不仅可以与部族的大灵和地脉进行沟通，还能通过这个仪式强化自己的实力。
OK， 这个大灵听起来好像是什么部族的监视者，
像部族的一个alarming
图腾和。
Those look like biblically accurate angels。
那也就是说，有了夜魂加持这种全新概念的加入，会导致纳塔会有一个完全不一样的体验。
对，
那我们作为设计者呢，其实也对这些体验做了一些
便利性的设计。那
我们从5.0开始，重新制作了一部分雪狮身手的活动场地。那大家可以看到，就雪狮身手的场地会变成一个。完全是纳塔风格的类似大世界这样的一个新区域，
对，
旅行者们就可以在这样的一个区域里面很方便的去测试角色的各项能力啊，进行更深度的游玩和体验。我知道肯定介绍完这三个角色之后，那大家也会再问一个问题，那旅行者在每个国家只要他触碰一下
，Yeah, where's Pyro Traveler？
这个国家的相关元素的对这个能力，那么在纳塔他是不是也能够很顺利的去接触到火元素的能力，并且也和这些角色一样？有夜魂加持的效果呢？
哎，提到这个就要提前和大家说明一下了。那么这次旅行者来到纳塔和七天神像进行初次共鸣的时候呢，由于某种不知名的原因，旅行者并不能立刻唤醒火元素力。那关于这个奇怪的现象，其实涉及到了我们现在纳塔面临到的一些种种的危机。
Interesting。
那等旅行者们在纳塔的旅程进
一步深入
的时候，就能够得到详细的解答了。
Maybe we have to beat What's Your Face in a fight。
除了刚才介绍得到这些新朋友啊，还有一些纳塔的角色，因为之前我们有过以凡辽著名的这样的一个视频。
对。
比如说啊，我们还有更早期的一个卫星角色，就是
足迹当中的伊安山。
对对对，就是足迹 PV 里已经露面的伊安山。包括像我有印象的还有恰斯卡，对吧，还有火神这样的角色，那么他们在剧情当中是否都会在 5.0 的版本中登场呢？
哎，七哥就观察得很仔细啊。那么我们先说
Aquaria， I was calling him Aquarius， I'm so rude。
个性洒脱，实力傲人，在各个部族中非常文明的调停人这么一个身份。
I don't know， I don't love her。 在
5.0 任务当中呢，他也会和我们一起参与。
Maybe I will later though， can't make judgments now， I gotta meet her first。
刚才提到的来自于沃路
之邦的
我们的健身教练兼微火盛宴巡礼冠军导师伊安山，他也会在我们的剧情当中为旅行者提供帮助。
那其实刚才在问答环节中啊，大家其实也反复提及的就是
火神还有
Don't worry, I'm sure Pyro Traveler will be at it later on. It just isn't going to be right away.
这一位，那么他们
都会在 I'm sure there's a lore region. That's interesting. It's shaking it up a little bit.
也期待就我们的队长和火神这两位强者对强者之间，他们会擦出怎样的火花吧。而在其他
A Song of Ice and Fire.
就比如说
What is that? That was the Game of Thrones
series. 来自湮弥主的希特拉利还有欧洛伦等等。
I want her so bad. Where's my leopard girl?
那么在介绍完角色之后呢，就接下来拜托我们鸡哥揭晓一下角色活动细节。终于到了大家万众期待的环节啊！那好，那就这次还是由我来给大家介绍一下5.0版本的起源活动安排。 那么在5.0版本的第一阶段，也就是上半段，我们的马拉尼，Kazuha is back，然后卡奇，Mulani is first，并且提升获取盖利亚普。而在卡奇的下半期呢，将会迎来基尼奇。She just raid up the one there banner.
That's annoying for me. For other people, I'm sure it's not. More time to save for
Kinnick。五星双手剑、山王长牙和五星法器。
I like Kinnick's weapon. Oh, and I like her surfs up. That's very cute. Okay, new forgeable weapons. Oh, they're pretty. I like them.
那在接下来的前瞻的一系列的活动当中，我们会推出一个名为"出发火之国"的 H5网页活动。那参与这个网页活动呢，旅行者不但能够直接看到
Oh, event we get the weapons. That's nice.
即将上线的5.0版本的新内容。 还能在版本更新后直接通过这个 H5的玩法获取三种纳塔地区的锻造武器。那所有关于这些活动的具体内容呢，也会在公告了解更多的活动详情。除了刚才说的全新的武器以外呢，5.0版本更新以后啊，我们还会增加两套新的
New artifacts, Scroll of the Hero of Sin City and Obsidian Codex. Ooh, I like the, well, honestly, the style of both of them is cool, but Obsidian Codex specifically is really cool. Challenging the main boss in that?
Okay.
What do they do? I want to know what they do, sir. Quaria. They're pretty, right?
追随大伟哥，所以大伟哥今天台上就只剩我一个人了吗？你可以自己想办法呀。哦，我自己想办法嘛。好好好，那我就先不说了，我待会去邀请一下我的小伙伴们来现场。
I'd be so nervous.
行
，I mean obviously.
请大家期待。
This must be your first time in Natland.
Yes, ma'am.
Chief says Natland's a little different from other nations because we live in
not like the other nations
rather than having one main city. But every time the pilgrimage rolls around, all six tribes gather at the stadium to compete and find the strongest warriors. See those people with the Tepetlosaurs? They're from my tribe.
Tepetlosaur, okay.
I come from the Children of Echoes. We're known for our mining skills. The
Tepetlosaurs
are our friends and co-workers too. They help us find the prettiest ores and gems. And that means my tribe has all the best jewelers.
Ooh,
when we
ice, okay.
Special gemstone, we use it to decorate our weapons or jewelry. Oh,
very
also,
cool.
If you have time, you should come watch one of our dance offs. They're super fun.
Well, not the Olympic breakdancing.
The contestants we just saw are from the people of the Springs.
That's right. We live alongside the Kaholosaurus.
Kaholosaur.
Our tribe is a really awesome vacation spot. Oh, sorry. Got lost in the music for a sec. The people of my tribe love getting together to go fishing, listen to music, and relax. Beyond that, our favorite thing is bathing in the hot springs.
Ooh, hot springs.
The Kaholosaurs like it too. That's why they're such good pals. But make sure you give them some space when it gets busy. And if a grumpy Kaholosaur bites you, do not bite them back.
Wasn't planning on it, but thank you, girl.
Covered in lava. If you plan to go exploring, I recommend picking a guide from my tribe.
Oh, they can swim in the lava as well.
Look no further than
very
the
cool.
Scions of the canopy.
Mm-hmm. We've got a lot of messengers. Everything from letters to packages. Being quick
the
on
music.
Our feet is one of our strengths. There's also our hunters, who take on a wide range of commissions.
Those idiots have a bigger death wish than you!
Extreme sports are popular in my tribe. Don't worry, the Yunkasaurs will protect them.
Yunkasaurs.
This region is inhospitable. Young people from my tribe come here because they like a challenge. Next up, there's...
Wait, wait, wait! Look! The competition's starting!
Next time, then.
Aw, not too much. We have to wait. New code, guys. 7SMTGV59BLXH. Very cool. I guess we'll get an intro to the next
three tribes when, you know, they're released. Thank you, Darcy. All right, guys, I'm sending this in chat as well. I'm almost done. We're a third done. Or two-thirds. Sorry, I can't count. Fun so far. I forgot how much more content there are in the nation updates, you know? Live stream. Oh.
Hey. 好, 各位旅行者, 欢迎回来。 那在这个环节呢,
where do I get one? I need one of those immediately.
那我的小伙伴现在也已经到场了, 他们到底是人还是龙啊? Hey, 说你们呢, 别睡了, 别睡了。 别睡了，节目都开始了。睡得真香啊！机会难得，你们给大家介绍一下你们自己。大家好，我是疾风龙啊，不对，我是原神的战斗设计师。Hello,
Yang，welcome。平时的主要工作呢，主要是做龙。然后今天呢，很高兴能到现场给大家亲自做一次龙。哎，大家好，我是原神的关卡设计师小巴。小巴，很荣幸呢，这次能够和大家介绍一下纳塔的场景和关卡设计。Meeting
so many new friends today, guys. So many new friends.
那今天啊，我们请到小巴还有老杨来到现场呢，其实是我们接着刚才的话题继续聊。我们已经知道了呀，就是纳塔是一个人和龙共生的国度。那刚才其实我们在
I know I need plushies, I need the hoodies, I need the T-shirts, I need it all. I do.
其实也跟其他的国家非常的不一样。
I really do.
是的，我其实也在网上看到了很多这样的评论。对于我们开发者来讲呢，纳塔也是一个非常具有特色的国度，潮酷和多彩是它的两个关键词。比方说，旅行者可以在巨大的山体上面看到多彩的涂鸦，或者是说在各个部落里面看到很多潮酷的要素。
哎，那这次我注意到一件事啊，就是老杨你怀里抱的这是个什么？
这应该是我们纳塔会随时陪着我们在任何一个小伙伴，就是在纳塔我们已经知道它是一个人和龙结合的国度，所以我们整个的设计理念是围绕着人和龙怎么做的结合。
没错，那上一趴我也有说到啊，就是。
旅行者可以通过一种附身的方式来附到纳塔的龙类身上，从而进行一些复杂的探索的行为。那接下来我就替老杨来介绍一下这位非常可爱的小伙伴吧。哦，
他也有什么来头吗？
旅行者们在纳塔探险的时候呢，就会遇到这一只特别的小疾风龙。我们暂时称它为小家伙吧。小家伙呢，它会陪伴我们经历很多有趣的小故事，并且也会参与到重要的世界任务当中哦。
那除了这个小疾风龙，这个小家伙以外啊，那我知道就是，刚才你也有谈到纳塔有非常多的部落的特色，那其实今天也很难得，我们有三个小龙人。That's my son, by the way, guys. Little one is my child, so. 不如这次我们就眼见为实，带着玩家去逛一圈。好呀，可以啊，来来来，我们先去我们疾风龙的部落去看一下我的老家。走走走，跟着我。Oh,
yeah, kind of like a Kangaskhan from Pokemon. I didn't think of that.这里啊，就是我们回声之子的部落。 Oh, we're getting some pretty gems.
大家可以看到啊，我们这个地方有很多的宝石，也有很多的矿石。同时呢，我们整个建筑的风格也看起来就跟岩元素很有关系。他已经是他们了，已经带入。是的，我们回声之子啊，
An excellent actor.
最强的战士，最强的战士才能够获得最好的宝石。所以呢，我们去深耕了一下挖掘相关的一些技术。
我来为老杨补充一下，就是在回声之子周围呢，也有不少因为钻探和挖掘而被发现的奇特景观，比如这处巨大的含有大量固态元素的流金之脉，以及一些很神秘的可以一直向下挖掘的洞穴等等。They
love big bones in Genshin.
I'm scared of them.
有很多值得去挖掘的区域，你刚才也说，对吧？你们部落是以宝石和挖掘做建长的，那你们的战斗伙伴，也就是疾风龙，想必也非常擅长这个领域的一些能力吧？疾风龙虽然在地面上移动，看起来憨态可掬，但是借助燃素，它可以在地下快速的移动，还能翻山越岭，同时也能帮我们回声之子去探查地下什么地方有宝石，所以它应该是你们这个部落的跑酷好手了。
哎，是的。
Parkour.
小巴，那边还有一处，好像是你们部落的。是的，这是我的老家。
I wonder if we can use them for mining and like getting certain rocks and stuff. I would love to use them to farm those rocks for a. That Sethos needs. Oh God, because I hate doing it myself.
流泉之众，就咱部落的人呢，是大多是热爱音乐。 然后以及喜欢泡泡温泉、休闲放松，然后包括他们的伙伴齐欧龙呢，日常也是一副懒散，甚至有那么一点迟钝的样子。虽然我们部族的人呢，经常看起来是这么一副安逸的样子，但当遇到真正的战斗以及比赛的时候，也都是一把好手。值得一提的是呢，咱部族的人也是纳塔少数的能够在液态燃素，是不是就那种？
看起来特别像岩浆的那种区域。对对对，我记得，因为之前我们也提到过液态燃素。那小巴哥，我们再介绍一下。好的啊，液态燃素区域呢，是我们看起来是比较像橙红色，很热，甚至有一点危险的这种地区。哎，那既然它这么危险的话，是不是我在周边游玩的时候要特别小心才行
？It's gonna be like those
electric rivers in Mizuma，或者说存在在一些比较有挑战性的区域，需要喜欢挑战的人呢，去体验。我们两个都说差不多了，鸡哥觉得缺点什么？那接下来就去看看我的老家，也就是聂龙的部族怎么样？好呀，行，那我来带路。These
are my people.
哎，这是什么呀？嘿嘿，这可是聂龙部落的宝藏人地图。
既然大家看到了聂龙部族这边有一个这么大的聂龙头像，那不如我们就从龙本身开始说起吧。
可以啊，看一下跟我们疾风龙还有小巴他们齐欧龙究竟有什么不同。没问题。那聂龙呢，它最强大的能力当然就是自己觅食的能力了。大家就看见啊，在聂龙的夹带当中，其实储存了一种很特殊的叫做火流果胶的物质。那每当聂龙要去觅食的时候呢，就会释放夹带当中的火流果胶，用它粘住果实，然后送入口中。 那在纳塔当然也会有一些富含燃素的果实，那聂龙呢也可以通过火灵果胶去吸收这些带有燃素的果实，并且在适当的时候去释放它们。
Oh my god, it's like
这种火流果胶呢，它不仅能够作为觅食的手段，在其他的时段里面，它还可以作为聂龙在
remember Yoshi's Island eventually
来回穿梭的这样的一个媒介。
那既然聂龙这么厉害，他们部族的人呢？
So stupid of a reference. I'm so sorry, but
I'm thinking about that.
I'm so biased. I can already tell this is gonna be.
在聂龙部族旁边呢，其实这么一个遍布高耸悬崖的遗迹——主遗庙宇。 和猎龙一起呢，旅行者说不定可以找到神秘的宝藏。
This really is my people. Oh lord.
我还是非常在意刚才说的吃果子这个事儿。我听过一个关于你们聂龙的八卦，不知道你听过没有？我感觉不是什么好八卦。我听说有一只聂龙平时不是很自律，然后呢，因为吃了太多的果子，导致身材发福，在洞穴下面再也回不来了。鸡哥，你可一定得保重啊！啊，原来是这么一回事。
Let him get fat and happy. Who cares?
Let the youth. Oh shoot, how do you pronounce it? Yumikasaur? They
can gain as much weight as they want. They have my seal of approval.
Hey, 老杨，就接着刚才那个聂龙的话题啊，我觉得我必须要为他说句公道话。虽然这只聂龙它又贪吃，体型又大，它确实也困在这地方出不来。但是呢，它实际上是聂龙当中非常古老的一只。哎，那你就会问了。 我们旅行者到底用什么方式来对付他们呢？那这一点确实老杨刚才说的有道理啊，就是他确实贪吃，所以旅行者们呢在跟他对战的过程中，可以找到一些对付他的弱点，比如说他喜欢吃的东西。
I'm really gonna cry.
我觉得鸡哥更像是在给自己垫底。He's so cute. He's just fat, stuck in a cave. 那我还不得不说一下
，Do you think if we brought a poker flute, we could get him out?
长上去还是挺可爱的。难道我们大海就全都是这种可爱画风的龙吗？就像我们三个一样。啊，那肯定不止。就像我们之前在宣传短片中提前放出的，有一只会飞的。No, I'm sorry. Is this a dragon or a wyvern? Because his arms are the wings.
哎，但是我怎么觉得纳塔的龙好像一般都是聚居的？为什么这只龙它会自己单独跑出来？它跟我们现在我们三个。
If they don't let us ride this, I'm riding.
这只巨大家伙呢是有一些特殊的原因。
I want to ride a dragon so badly and get you have no idea.
得已而为之，最后离开了自己的族群，生活在这片区域。啊，除了刚才我们介绍过的
这个胖胖的聂龙和神秘的巨大飞龙呢？
我们在纳塔的旅程中还有许多神奇的生物，比如说看上去就很容易被撞飞的鸟、
oh, so、
看上去就很憨的豚兽，看上去就很热的甲虫，还有一些看上去就很会飞的老鼠。
除了刚才老杨讲
到的这些奇特生物以外呢，在纳塔还有很多风格迥异的场景，比如说神秘的高难度的夜神试炼，还有巨大的间歇喷发的火山，未来呢也会给旅行者们开放。
这个大
家可以尽情期待。 I'm not killing nobody for me.
大家都知道我们在每个国家推出的时候都会有一套叫声望系统的系统内容。那这一次在 5.0 的版本，我们对这个声望系统做了一次全新的尝试。
Oh, new reputation.
那这一次呢，旅行者可以在各个部落的一个叫钥匙图腾柱的地方去接取对应部族的讨伐悬赏和务虚通告。
哎，那这听上去不还是声望系统吗？
基哥，你别骗我。
Each tribe has its own reputation。
声望系统没有什么区别啊，但是呢，我还是说漏了一点。
Hey, I mean, hey, more rewards.
环节当中，我有。
That's gonna be annoying though, because you're gonna have to prioritize which one you want. Oh, I hope we get different wings for each one.
这个祭文呢，除了包含
That could be very exciting.
和周边的风土人
New fashion, new drip for the characters.
纳塔的角色
really cool.
传说任务哦， oh, 也就是说包含上述所有的内容在内，每一个部族都将陆续开放三个章节供玩家游玩。所以我们纳塔的传说任务其实是换了一种新的形式出现的。
My Arlecchino needs wings that aren't the default ones.
在 5.0 版本还有更多以单元剧形式出现的
I know. A girl can dream though, right?
世界任务，比方说刚才介绍到的以小家伙为主角的世界任务。
What's world quest?
好好好、那我们一口气介绍了这么多的包括场景啊，包括我们战斗的一些 boss 呀、啊，包括刚才说的任务。那么接下来我们再跟旅行者们介绍一下这次 5.0 版本的活动。
Two gliders, I'll take two. Two I'm okay with.
来为大家介绍一下。
Ideally, let's say three. I would like three, but I will take two.
这次我们也为旅行者们准备了很多丰富多彩的活动，比如纳塔探索的导览，还有前往提瓦特各处打卡的旅行回顾。完成其中一个活动呢，还能获得一个四星法器。值得一提的是，即使旅行者们已经游玩过的一些挑战
了，在
纳塔也会以一个完全不同的形式呈现。
这里我要替他说一句，我们也为旅行者准备了一些特殊的游玩的短片。哦，具体有多不一样，我们一起看一下就知道了。
好，那我们就看一看。
好，
这次呢，我们纳塔呢带来了很多全新的玩法，今天也邀请了几个朋友到现场来实际体验一下。我就先带着大家跑一段现实挑战。这个地方有一个龙灵，这是疾风龙部落的，然后我们可以魂附到这个龙灵上，就可以开始我们的挑战了。进去以后呢，开右扳机你就钻到地下了。在这个过程里面呢，我们需要借助我们这个小龙的特点啊，去
哦、oh, so there's like little paths that'll make you take to oh oh you swap like me oh
这就是个错误示范
me
这个地方呢又要切回我们疾风龙了。
墙上这个红色的石头
you can swap mid challenge。
还行，
厉害厉害，
一百，也就是
101到101吧。哦，哎呀，
咱们教学也就先
报一张。So close, you got it.
立刻进入比赛，怎么样
？Competition, I'm intrigued.
咱两两组队，互相比一下挑战用时和挑战得分。
漏了，
我怎么感觉我上来就漏了？
感觉我们有戏了。
然后上去，飞机，
是不是漏了一个？
那你要相信我。
你转头看看呗。
They're trying to get in their heads. This is serious business. 哎，
哦，我怎么感觉我下面又漏了？
来，准备到你了啊！
来了来了
来了，
给！
哎，怎么换来的？哎，打开了人数视野，
不愧是我教的呀！
哎，咱先把他跑，哎，对，回到正轨，可以可以。
He's got it.
哦，
第一次嘛，
还可以，
最高评分应该是 B。
Okay. Missed a couple.
那必须的。耶、yeah?。
You got it.
压力逐渐减小。
攻击攻击。准备要接手了。
交吗
？She said，
啊，怎么不换好给我？快说！
加油加油！哎，
啊 ，She's doing well。刚
接操作了。
I was, I knew she would win.
一般一般，也没满嘛，对不对？
原神五点零版
本也即将上线，马上就给旅行者们端上来了。到时候我们大家一起去纳塔去体验这些新鲜的玩法吧。
期待。
旅行者们欢迎回来！哇，我终于从逆夜龙的形态解脱了。那坐在我身边的呢，就是大家的老朋友，原神的国内市场负责人 Michael。
大家好。
这次说还也巧啊，我们的五点零版本刚好撞上周年庆啊。
是哎，那说起周年庆，那就必须带上我们的传统技能。
没错，那么在这次五点零版本期间呢，通过周年庆的签到活动，我们会为各位旅行者送出十枚纠缠之源。另外，我们也会通过邮件向大家发放包括1600元石在内的诸多奖励，其中还包含一个全新的跟宠和一个有趣的炸弹玩具小道具。
New pad, new gadget, very exciting！
对对对，我们也会在这个版本去重置大家的首充双倍福利。
嗯，那福利的环节就到这里。
哦，
那接下来让我来介绍一下。
等等等等等等等
啊！
那福利的环节为什么就到这里
？20 pulls。
我们每年的福利不是
啊？
哎。难道大伟哥没有跟你讲过吗？
啊，他跟我讲什么了？
那么，这个你见过吗？
这什么？啊、这么厚吗
？Michael， 你真不知道吗？
真不知道。
别慌，别慌，别慌。那我们就带入 Michael 的视角，我们和旅行者们一起来一条一条分享一下我们这个版本做出的福利以及相关优化。
嗯，
在5.0版本期间。旅行者们只要完成魔神任务荣花与炎日之厨，也就是我们5.0的主线、
嗯、
就可以在活动界面直接领取额外的500元石。
刚刚说到的是完成主线就有更多的原石吗？
没错啊。
那还有提到一点是5.0版本期间才有，那是只有5.0才有吗？
哎，那可不是了，在接下来的5.0、5.1和5.3版本，也就是我们的主线重要篇章发布的这些版本，都可以拿到这样的限时奖励，也就是有更多的额外的500元石。
Oh, so if you do them in the patch that they come out in, you get bonus prima gems.
我刚才有讲到魔神任务啊，那
接下来我们
要去讲一讲传说任务了。
I love that so much.
在后续的新角色，无论他们是以不足祭文还是以传说任务的形式出现他们的故事的时候，只要玩家在当前的版本进行了这些任务的体验，就可以获得额外的奖励了。
That's really nice. I actually love that a lot.
那具体有哪些奖励？
哎，这些奖励包含额外的原石，以及还有对应角色突破等级2和突破等级3所需要的所有培养材料哦。我们就拿5.0版本的马拉尼来举例子。首先我们会有血誓身手的活动，马拉尼可以突破到突破等级1，对不对？
嗯。
然后因为马拉尼有不足祭文任务，也就是说接下来他还会陆续获得突破等级2和突破等级3的所有材料。
嗯。
也就是说玩家几乎不用付出任何的额外努力，他就能直接将马拉尼快速升到60级。嗯、
What？
那说明现在养新角色的这个培养压力就一下子下来了。
没错，这样也是能够为我们的新老玩家第一次接触到新角色的时候，就是能铺平很多原先遇到的阻碍。
That's really nice。
对于新加入的这些旅行者，他们好像不能立刻赶到纳塔。对于他们。有什么样的安排？
那 Michael， 你的意思是说，假如我是一个初来乍到的旅行者，
对的，
我没有办法第一时间体会到这些任务，那我就拿不到对应的原石奖励了。
是的，是的，
这一点我们当然也都考虑到了。所以在后面呢，我们也开放了一个新的功能，是主线快速开启功能。在5.0版本更新以后，只要完成了璃月的主线魔神任务，并且达到了冒险等级28级，就可以直接在活动界面开启纳塔的主线剧情了。
那太好了，就是之前还有一些朋友会问我嘛，什么时候入坑？
Wait，
最好，那我觉得就是现在了。
哎，我还要给大家补充一条信息哦，就是快速开启的这个功能在后续版本也会陆续开启。
那让我再追问一下吧，之前忙碌在外的一些旅行者或许会返回到提瓦特大陆再看一看、嗯、那对于我们这些回归的老朋友是不是也应该有些表示啊？
你知道在原神原先的版本里面有一个针对回归玩家的活动叫星之归
环，
对，那么在 5.0 版本呢，我们对星之归环的奖励也做了一定的调整，除了原本的原始奖励以外呀，还有一些长期没有回归到提瓦特的旅行者们，那这些旅行者呢还会额外在星之归环活动中领取至多10枚纠缠资源。
哦、oh, ，10 extra pulls for doing stuff， nice。
旅行者可以参考后续的官方公告和游戏内的指引。
等等， 那新玩家跟老朋友都照顾到了，
没错。
那像我这种一直坚守在
，Yeah, what about us hardworking, dedicated fans?
我们也提了很多的优化意见跟想法。那有没有针对我们的一些内容呢？
那当然了，我们一直在强调，其实《原神》的开发组啊，一直在持续的关注和倾听玩家的反馈。那么接下来，我还有更多的调整和优化，就是针对玩家的反馈所做出的。在 5.0 版本更新以后呢，只要旅行者们点击背包当中对应区域特产的野外采集选项，我不知道大家有没有注意过啊，就是区域特产一直有一个只可观看不可点击的野外采集地点推荐，
没错。
对，那么现在呢，只要你点击了这个选项，
it'll tell you where to go get them，
自动追踪这些区域特产的采集地点。
That's nice。
不仅如此，你还可以通过这个自动追踪功能来监控这些区域里面剩余特产的可采集数量。
哇，那也太舒服了吧！那怪物的掉落的这个
character leveling you get
做一下优化。
Up to levels, you can ascend them to level 60 now with the trial rewards instead of just 20.
那么在这一次啊，我们也针对这样的一个反馈做了一些调整。在 5.0 版本更新以后呢
，Oh, it's the character quest. I thought it was the trial. My bad.
会获得提升，其中啊就包括 Michael 你刚才提到的海浪鬼和漂浮灵。
Everyone up, that's really nice.
那怎么样提升啊？
大家可以看到我们视频上面的一些掉落素材的对比啊，
这好明显。
对，当然如果只是
Oh my God, remember the original handguard drops? That was so funny back in the day. You would fight those things. Sometimes they don't even drop anything. That was such a nightmare.
开放世界等级的世界等级九，
世界等级九吗？
没错。Right, level 9, they dropped that in-depth discussion.
大家会想，世界等级九会非常困难。但是对于这些实力强大的旅行者，他可以很轻松地挑战世界等级九的这些任务的同时呢，还会获得更丰厚的掉落奖励。我必须要强调一下，这些掉落奖励呢，也包含首领敌人在内。
等等，让我捋一捋。那就是说，刚刚世界等级提升后的这个增加材料的掉落，以及包括整体的这个怪物掉落的这个内容的增加，两个效果是可以叠加的吗？
没错，这两个效果是完美叠加的。所以 Michael， 你的理解能力很强啊！
哇，真那有点不得了啊！
Michael， 你已经听到这里了，难道你
？Bro, because you need Arlecchino for level 9, ain't no way.
我还有一些痛点，就我必须要今天就替玩家去说，剩余物。我也一直觉得应该优化的。那你们有安排吗？
啊，那当然了。那当然，那当然了。就是剩余物啊，我觉得大家这么多年下来，对原神的剩余物主要是吐槽两个点啊。就是第一个点叫剩余物转狗粮。第二个点叫一个极品剩余物的胚子。我们先说剩余物分解的事情啊。旅行者们在分解剩余物之前，不是只能分解出摩拉吗？那么这次啊，我们分解剩余物之后，可以将它转化为剩余物的经验素材了。也就是说，大家不用再担心说不舍得分解这些剩余物而占大家的背包空间了。
哎，我以前就是因为有一些生命磁条跟防御磁条，不知道应不应该把它拿掉，所以我一直都存着，我的背包是一直满的状态。
对，然后存着的时候呢，你又不太愿意把它直接换成魔了。
对，万一后面有角色要用到，那
I do that too. I'm like, what if I need this?
没错，好。那刚才 Michael 其实提了一个很重要的问题啊，就是他如果到了关键的时候，却又没有办法为后续的角色获取对应的剩余物，就会感觉自己很矛盾，对不
对？
对
的，
那么除了剩余物转化为培养材料以外呢，我们还推出了第二个很重磅的功能，叫做祝圣之霜。
祝圣之霜。这个名字听起来有点厉害。
这个名字听起来很厉害，它的功能其实更厉害。旅行者们可以通过使用祝圣之霜来兑换指定磁条的剩余物。
指定磁条吗？
没错，这个指定磁条不仅能够指定主磁条的属性种类，还可以额外指定两个副磁条的属性。
副磁条也能？
没错。
那我的双爆岂不是？
对，跟你想的一样。5.0 版本的铸圣之霜呢，大家可以通过萃取一定数量已经升级的剩余物，或者说探索纳塔的大世界，或者说解锁我们的珍珠纪行，达到指定的等级来获取。刚才我们是不是有提到周年
庆的邮件奖励？ They can't save me from bad rolls though. They can give me double crit, but they can't save me from bad rolls.
附赠了一部分铸圣之霜供大家使用。
I never thought they were going to add something like this.
的东西在吗？
没错。 关于铸圣之窗的详细获取规则和消耗规则呢，后续也可以参照游戏内的相关指引。
Okay, so it's gonna, we'll tell us how to get it.
我知道之前一直也有旅行者吐槽啊，觉得我们寄行奖励的很多物品我已经用不上了，包括可能我已经溢出的锻造用魔矿，包括可能哎我在某个国家的角色呢，他们的天赋等级已经都养满了，
对对
对, 对，但是你还在持续给我提供这个国家的天赋，是不是感觉很尴尬？
是的。
哎，那么从 5.0 版本开始呢，我们的寄行奖励也会进行调整。
Ooh, new battle pass,
首先是在进行开始的时候、
okay.
旅行者们就可以从这四种养成资源中任选其中三种、嗯、作为本次进行可获取的奖励、嗯、也就是说你可以通过自己的需求来查漏补缺了
Artifact EXP、嗯、
此外呢如果旅行者们解锁了珍珠戒行或者珍珠之歌、嗯、并且在达到对应等级之后我们原本指定国家的角色天赋培养素材会变成能够让旅行者自由选择任意国家的角色天赋培养素材。
哎，等等，七哥，你现在说的真的是什么？
包括你还记不记得我们的旅行者为了提升我们队伍的体力上限，他必须得把蒙德和璃月的齐天神像供奉至满级，对不对
？Are they getting rid of that? That's kind of sad.
你觉得这个问题该不该解决
？No.
对啊，不然。玩家直接到了纳塔或者说体验其他的国度他就体力值就没有办法涨了
没错所以既然我们做了主线快速开启那么一定要把相关的所有的细节都优化到底嗯，从 5.0 版本更新开始旅行者们就可以通过供奉任意区域的七天神像来增加自己的体力值上限、
oh, OK actually that's fine
从纳塔开始纳塔的七天神像纳塔的地灵
开 Can I be honest guys? I don't like that you can skip the nations I feel like I might be unpopular opinion I don't. I think you should do the story in the order that comes like I don't know I feel like you should do it when it comes out
有超过十枚纠缠之源的价值哦
居然又多了
I know no I know but like I personally don't like that
也有点动力要
Objectively yes I agree that it's good I personally just don't like it
结束了吧
80 primos is nice though.
你希不希望？你希不希望这个福利结束
？That's true. Yeah, I you have to realize not everyone plays the game as me.
哎，你看我手卡已经用完了呀。
But you know, or the not everyone plays the game the same way. And some people just don't care about the arc quests or the order or blah blah blah, which I understand.
给我留了后。
Michael， 你要知道啊，或者我们的旅行者大家要知道，一般节目的高潮啊都要留到后面的。
I understand it. I don't like it. You know.
我都还没有说到重量级的信息。
哎，大伟哥。来之前完全没有跟我说过有这些东西啊
那么这次我也不做
Hi, Ryan.
顺序安排由 Michael 自己去
Oh Ryan I'm on Twitch sorry
那我先抽这个吧
先抽这个对不对你觉得你确定
确定
OK 好嗯刚才啊我们有一位朋友说到过希望他能够把玩家 Y 小保底的不好的运气都转到他身上对吧我们也很佩服这位旅行者的勇气但是接下来我要公布的这一项福利可以稍微的分担一下这位旅行者的负担
50-50 changes
你想不想替各位旅行者先体验一下、
What?
那我就替各位旅行者先验验货了啊
好那么麻烦我们的工作人员好谢谢
谢谢
好 Michael 试试看
嗯哎这个特效怎么跟之前的不一样了呀不会是我欧皇附体了吧
这其实是我们在 5.0 版本的角色活动起源当中新加入的一个事件叫做捕获明光
Capturing
捕获明光这个是什么东西、啊、
我给你们解释一下也就是当玩家呀、啊、常说的小保底到来的时候有概率会遇到捕获明光事件当这次事件出现的时候呢抽取的结果必定为当期的 UP 五星角色
但是哦我比较好奇啊这个事件会挤占以前的大小保底的概率吗
哎知道你就会这么问我相信旅行者们也非常关心这样一个问题那么捕获明光它关键就关键在它只是单纯提高了小保底抽中当期 UP 的机会并不会影响这个游戏其他所有的概率规则也就是说你简单理解为我们抽中当期 UP 的概率提高了就这么简单
这个消息还是蛮爆炸的
更详细的信息会在后续的官方公告和游戏内的概率公式详情给大家一一说明
那接下来还有吗
Michael 你觉得这个消息都不算爆炸性消息是吗
我觉得已经挺爆炸了
啊，不过呀既然你都这么问了
They raised the chance so it's not 50-50 anymore
这三个消息中最不爆炸的一个我们再试试武器神柱复行祈愿
好我点出去看看
记得先定轨哦
哎 不对吧？这个定轨的数字好像有点问题。
哎，哪个数字有问题啊？
这怎么变成了一啊？
你并没有看错，从5.0版本更新开始，我们的神柱复形起源，也就是武器池，它的定轨上限会从2调整到1。
不会吧？
We won.
War
is over. We won.
简单，你们肯定会从别的地方把它抠回来的。
啊，你看 ，Michael 的这个质问就非常的，让我非常的有既视感。Oh my god！ 但是我还是得坦诚的跟大家讲， 这一次武器的起源，
I have an R2 Vortex Vanquisher，
仅此而已。我们没有变动其他所有的原有的规则。我还有最后一条更劲爆的
消息。What else? I'm gonna die.
还要跟 Michael 和各位。
I can't believe this.
你别吓我，我刚刚开玩笑了。我只是玩家的嘴替，我开个玩笑。
What's going on? I'm like, I have to actually set up.
对吧？那这次我们确实是真诚的，想给大家再送上一次非常劲爆的福利。
难道说？
没错。那么在今天呢？我在这里去公布我们这一次 5.0 前瞻节目的最后一条福利投放的消息，也就是从今年开始，每年原神的周年庆版本期间，我们都会向已经解锁了祈愿系统的所有旅行者提供一次免费获取奔行世间祈愿包含的任意一名五星角色的机会。
所以不仅是一个自选的常驻五星，还是每年一个自选常驻五星吗？
对，你没有听错，是
从你确定吗？你在这里说了之后不能反悔啊！很多人看到我们直播，
没错，我说的很清楚，是从今年开始，每年原神的周年庆活动都会给大家这样一个自选常驻五星的机会。
I'm gonna get。
而且我们的这个常驻池是一直加新角色。
I'm gonna get C3 Tainari。
随着我们版本的推进啊，其实会有越来越多的角色加入到奔行世间祈愿当中，也就是说每年的这个福利也会随着版本的推进，它的选项会逐渐丰富起来。怎么样？你觉得这个
福利？我说实话，我鸡皮疙瘩都起来了。我今天这个，我真的有点懵啊，就是
I'm gonna die。
哇，我没想到今天的福利居然是这样的。
I wasn't expecting
any of this。我感觉你的心情还没有
出。我
刚才的
我有点
这些消息都缓过来了。
对，我确实有点没缓。
那我们给 Michael 一点冷静的时间。
I'm so excited. I'm so excited.
跟大家去说几句，我们虽然是原神这个游戏的开发者，但同时我们也是原神的玩家。这一点一直从 1.0 开始。我都在不断地跟大家传达这样一个信息。那么玩家提出的一切的问题，我们作为玩家当然也都是感同身受的。
是的，
因为原神接下来要走的路也很困难也很长，但是我希望它能够一直延伸下去。我们能够一直走下去也离不开大家一直以来的持续关注和支持。
没错。
那么接下来就到了 Michael 的回合了。
虽然我觉得我们所准备的内容不如刚刚的惊喜，但是我们准备的周年庆相关内容呢，比往年还是只多不少。我们想带给大家的其实很简单，旅行者们能够收获一些简单的快乐，我们就非常满足了。
我们平时也非常重视每位旅行者的声音。
Oh,
我觉得项目组的大家其实都是发自内心的去认可，还是要以高品质的核心内容创作作为它最重要的基石。我们要持续不断地去做出好内容本身，这才是我们一直能够走下去的立身之本。那如果说我们做的内容没有让玩家没有让旅行者感受到乐趣，那一定是我们哪里出现了问题。我们会非常非常乐意去收集大家的看法进行调整。
七哥突然之间感慨起来了呢。
那么接下来还是
再看一些有意思的短片来转换一下气氛吧。
Look at this animation, how pretty. I like. Ooh.
This is really cool. I'm like not even blinking. I'm sorry. I probably look crazy. This is so cool.
Yay!
10 out of 10. Last redemption code 8T4TGDLRA5E5. And the new anniversary. I'm very emotional right now. I'll send this in TikTok too for you guys. Kinnick is so cool, I agree. Heavy, I'm a big Kinnick fan. I thought Mulani was gonna be my favorite, but I think I'm definitely leaning towards Kinnick more. A very sweet message. I think that was their way of addressing a lot of the things that have been going on that have been a little bit unsavory within the community and just everything going on. But
I actually
Imaginarium change.
Those
macarons do look delicious, right? I was thinking that there's a
lot of wanja the genie, she should get a woman, the dead lingan. So you almost from 4.8开始, to each side do you go on for Jinxing Tiao.那在接下来即将更新的 5.0 版本当中呢，我们全量重新设计了玩法当中的奇妙注意事件。那在新的版本当中呢，这些事件将根据当期的三元素所对应的反应体系进行有效清晰的策略引导。简单来讲，就是你拿到这个注意的时候就已经知道。
Next one's gonna be Dendro and Pyro. It's looking like in Hydro. That's it. Next three.
我都看的
spoilers.
OK.
没错没错，这也是很真实的一个玩家反应。
是的。
那这些注意事件呢，也将提供非常强大的特殊元素反应机制，也就是他们是贴合原有的反应体系去制作的。即使玩家对自己手头能够出战的角色机制不够了解，他也能够简单的通过元素搭配来展开有效的进攻策略。这本来也是我们去设置每一期元素主题的初衷。
嗯，
那当然了，可能会有玩家会问啊，那如果你们设置了这么强大的体系增益之后，会不会导致这些玩法越发的没有挑战性？所以在 5.0 版本呢，我们对于追求更高难度的挑战者也会开启新的卓越模式。卓越模式当中所对应的奖励
An even harder mode already. I'm so down. I'm so excited for that.
对我们后续推出的玩法
That's sick. Hey, Star, how are you? We're watching the live stream.
Rewards
and harder rewards.
Oh, TCG.
Oh, Feminine Shenyun.
Pretty.
Amazing support card. Cute.
另外还有联动活动要跟大家分享。指腹双印原定在预，原神与罗技的首次联动即将到来。
罗技吗？
没错。定制款罗技产品将在九月的罗技 Play 发布会上与大家正式见面。罗技的社媒平台啊，也即将公布联名产品信息。此外，还有多种联名周边可以获取。各位旅行者喜欢的话，千万不要错过。
哇，罗技的定制款哎，你要知道我从小到大用的都是罗技的外设，哇，这可太酷了。
嗯
，Michael， 听说你今天应该还给大家带来了一些音乐方面的消息。
I actually could use a new headset, so hopefully they have a white one.
必须在这个环节给大家分享。据我所知啊，纳塔的音乐风格跟枫丹相比起来是要特殊的非常多的。
I already low key already like it better than the Fontaine music. I might be biased, but I do.
矿泉水入席就坐，纳塔交响音乐会马上开始。
Symphony, oh fun. I don't have any sunflower seeds or peanuts though. I'm kind of mad.Start making it a little louder. Goosebumps. Does anyone know what language this is in? I can't. Wait, no, this is it. No, because this is it. Swahili? Okay. The headband. Love that. There's more. I'm just trying to hold up and not talk in the middle of it, but oh my god. Listen, Leeway music and Sumer music are getting a run for their money right now. That's all I'm gonna say. You know how much I love Leeway music. Better be like the fight music. Okay. I don't know if they include these vocals in the game, they win. Notlin wins. I'm so... Oh, it's so good. It's so good. It, like, scratches your brain. It's so excellent. I'm loving this. God, it's 1:30 in the morning. Jesus. Is this also Swahili? Seems different. This is too good. Instrument is that on the arm there? It's like a little drum almost. I'm not gonna lie, when that original composer left, I was concerned the music quality would drop, but they still got it. So good.
表现是我自我还是不是那么满意啊，而且是压力也是相当大。
Excellent.
不过我觉得如果旅行者们能喜欢我们这次纳塔的内容的话，我觉得效果就已经到位了。
那今天介绍完这个今天的内容啊，我这里还有最后一个问题啊，也是之前问卷中有玩家提到的，就是项目组啊内部对于原声未来有什么样的规划，有没有什么可以提前透露的一些有趣内容啊？
The harmonies are beautiful.
我先说规划的问题吧。
Everything was so good.
在此之前我想提个题外话，就是在到期版本上线的那一年，我记得有一个海外媒体的朋友有问我一个问题，说这一年的开发感受如果用一个词来概括的话，你觉得什么样的词最合适？
I don't know what the referencing right now.
当时我其实用了一个词叫进化，这个词不光是指我们整个团队为了去做更多原先从未体验过的内容所做出的个人努力，所做出的团队的进化，另一方面其实也是直到今天大家看到的像纳塔这样的内容也是我们这个进化之路上的其中一小步。那每年我们都会努力。
When I think about how long it's been since we started Genshin, man, I get like emotional. My life is so different from back then. I was back in college.
刚才也问在故事上我们有没有什么长线规划，我们会在未来的旅途上遇到更多的伙伴和敌人，那么他们其中有一些呢一直活在坊间传闻当中，那还有一些呢可能迄今为止和玩家只有一面之缘，玩家和他们也不甚了解，那还有一些呢可能他们对旅行者是陌生的，对于提瓦特的众人也是陌生的，但是这些人和世界的命运之间也是息息相关的。那旅行者前往寻找自己血亲的这个旅途实际上也会和这个世界之间的联系因为上述的原因越来越紧密。
那么基哥也给我们介绍了很多原神未来的规划，那也是让我们对未来啊充满着期待。我们今天的那个前瞻特别节目啊到这里呢也就接近尾声了。那原神到现在啊都已经四年了，我也有很多心里话啊想跟我们旅行者讲。我们一起从2020年的那个秋天启程呢，已经是相伴走过了四个年头。 那共同度过了许多难忘的时刻。那随着这个探索的步伐不断前行啊，那提瓦特的这个大陆也是愈加的这个丰富多彩。那我也相信未来的每一片新的地域啊，每一段新的故事啊，会成为我们最美好的这个回忆啊。
I'm getting upset.
那过去的这一年啊，原神项目组和我、啊、都是曾经经历了这个焦虑和迷茫。
Anxiety. Me too,
girl. 我们听到了很多的声音、
啊。Me and you both.
有的把原神吹上天，有的把原神啊贬得一无是处啊。这样的声音多了啊，难免让项目组和我都有点不知所措。我自己回想起原神这一路走来啊，其实旅行者的热情、期望与反馈啊，让我们有了不断前行的这个动力啊，也是原神啊能够不断进步的这个源泉。于是啊，今年上半年啊，原神项目组和我、啊、决定去跟世界各地的旅行者面对面聊聊。我们去了很多我们从来没有去过的城市，比如湖北襄阳啊，比如巴西圣保罗啊。在跟全球各地的旅行者面对面的时候啊，每一位旅行者都非常激动地跟我们分享他们的提瓦特旅程啊。他们有的还在每天体验原神，有的呢只是新版本更新上来体验一下，有的呢已经很久没有来过提瓦特。跟他们聊完呢、啊、制作组和我重新理解了旅行的意义啊。我们的脑子里啊想起了那句啊，我们终将重逢啊。我们意识到啊，只有对旅行者的陪伴是原神
唯一不
能改变的，
Stop.
其他一切皆可改变。也正是因为有了各位旅行者、啊、我们才有机会在未来带来更多精彩优质的内容。最后呢，我们将在8月28日迎来全新的 5.0 版本火之国纳塔。那这片炙热而神秘的土地啊，也是等待着每一位勇敢的旅行者前去探索。感谢大家一直以来的支持与陪伴，愿你们的纳塔之旅充满惊喜与期待。旅行者们，我们纳塔见。
I'm getting emotional. It's been so long. You know what's crazy, guys? So it's not good time. Oh, what does that mean? Does anyone, can someone translate for me, please?
我感觉他们很放松，比我们之前这个我在场的时候要轻松很多。
鸡哥怎么回事？都不提前跟我商量一下。还有不是跟我说是综艺效果吗？怎么整的是
我、啊、laughing at him.
啊，我不知道，龙龙不知道，我只是一条孽龙，你不要来找我，是大尾龙要我干的，要找到大尾龙去啊。
我不在的时候
they call him Diwasaurus. That's actually
crazy. 好玩吗？好玩，咋了？
上不上 bug 单？
像你的 bug 单拿着吧。你
我就看你还修不修你 bug。
修完了，
走走走，赶紧回去修 bug 去。
看你修 bug。
The bloopers reel is very cute. Oh, anniversary messages?
Hello, travelers, and welcome to Teyvat Talks.
Yay.
I'm Zach Aguilar, voice of Ether, co-hosting with my friend and voice
Ether?
Of Albedo, Koi Dao.
Huh, friend, huh?
Ether?
The best friends. Like that one time you played Wind Trace without me?
Hey everyone!
I've been saying Aether all this time.
To be part of the 4th anniversary celebration this year.
Oh my god, everyone gets a free Albedo, yes!
Years. That's crazy. Okay. I can't believe it's been so long. These past 4 years, I've had the pleasure of delivering some epic grunt sounds as Aether, voicing emotional dialogue in the Archon quests, and working on the
Aether,
special
I can't
programs.
Believe it's Aether.
So many great memories have been made, not only working on the game, but also playing it. What do you think, Koi?
Oh my gosh, 4 years.
OMG.
Wow. You know, I turned 4 years old once.
Oh.
It was awesome.
Thank you for that.
Back then, I never thought I'd get to voice such a cool and intelligent character in an exciting game like Genshin Impact. We know that many of our fellow castmates have had some fun, sometimes truly unbelievable experiences over the past 4 years. So let's bring in a few special guests too.
I really thought it was Aether.
Turn the unknown into the known.
Let's do it.
Oh, wow.
Let's go.
Let's go. Yay.
Happy 4-year anniversary, everyone!
Nahida.
I'm Kimberly Ann Campbell, the voice of Nahida. And I know what you're thinking. A lot of people are like, wow, you sound so different from Nahida.
Yeah, she puts on a good voice.
One time during a rare live stream for me, someone in the chat told me to prove that I was actually the voice of Nahida.
Thank you so much for the follow.
So,
welcome to stream. How are you?
And in person at conventions, I get a handful of people who seem to be very surprised that that voice comes out of my body. What can I say? It's just what I sound like.
Yeah, she puts on. She's good.
I usually whip out a "everyone hold hands" to prove I'm not lying.
That's great. I couldn't even do that if you paid me.
Yeah, that's super relatable. Like, I usually just scream Windblade at people to prove that it's me, or make a
"everybody hold hands"
sound,
or even just in your private moments.
Yeah,
I've heard you scream it.
Exactly.
Oh.
I turn to my right side and I scream "Windblade." It helps scare away the demons.
That's weird. You're a weird guy.
Anyways, here's more guests.
Anyways.
I'm so lucky that I get to see a lot of Genshin Impact fans and cosplayers, especially the Raiden Shogun cosplayers, at conventions all over the world.
I'm assuming Tide is going to be the Archon.
It's so cute.
Oh my god, Farina.
Come up to my table and realize that I don't usually sound like her. So someone will come up and say, "Oh, are you the voice of Raiden Shogun? Oh yeah, that's me. Can you do a line?" And I'll be like, "Inazuma shines eternal." And watching their eyes light up always makes me smile. Genshin Impact fans are so passionate, and I love you guys.
We are a crazy bunch of people. Passionate is a nice way of putting it.
I personally have a lot to celebrate. When Genshin Impact dropped, almost immediately, my life began to change in a measurable way. I began to meet more and more people.
I love
online,
Keith.
At conventions.
His voice is so...
And honestly, in my daily life.
So good.
Who are so passionate about this game. And I've learned that I love to sneak up on Genshin Impact cosplayers, and then when I'm right behind them, say something like, "This is an age of gods and monsters. I wish
He's
not
so
for the
good.
Meaning, yet I cannot watch the common folk suffer." I mean, the reactions are... genuinely priceless.
He has such a good
And I frequently hear from
y'all.
People online that that was one of the highlights of their con. I meet people that are so excited about this game that they literally tear up.
Me crying.
I mean, honestly.
Because Dawei said, "Thanks for playing the game," and I start crying like a psycho.
Aw, that's so sweet.
Wow.
And that is such a funny thing to do at conventions. Can you imagine sneaking up on people and suddenly speaking in voice? Except I just get really shy. Yeah.
I would so do that. I would terrorize people if I was a voice actor, just to be annoying.
Okay, first off, I want to give a big thank you to the team at Genshin Impact for letting me play the most beautiful man I have ever seen. Seriously, Nouvellet is a prized character of mine, one I'm just so excited to play and dig into for years to come. While he does have a range of subtle emotional beats and some true cathartic twists, nothing about him can possibly compare to the elephant seal in the room. The month of Oratrice Mechanique d'Analyse Cardinale
that
changed
my life. That was insane, that trend.
Who could possibly have seen that coming? Genshin Impact fans are so polite whenever I meet them. They never ask me to say it, but of course I always do. And their gratitude about, "He said the thing," is always a palpable
He said the thing!
All right, let's do it. Oratrice Mechanique d'Analyse Cardinale. Thank you.
That voice goes crazy.
He said the thing! He said the thing!
He did say the thing. You say the thing.
Oratrice Mechanique d'Analyse Cardinale.
Oratrice Mechanique d'Analyse Cardinale.
Whoa, where did that voice come from? Hold on.
So who's the most beautiful man you've ever seen,
Whoa.
Jack?
Pause.
There's a correct answer.
When I looked into your eyes, Koi.
Who said that?
Go on.
So, Isaiah, thank you so much for the follow. Welcome.
That the most beautiful
man
I ever saw was the reflection in your eyes, me!
I knew it. I knew it.
I don't know what's happening.
Where it was going.
Hair flip.
Well, that was fun.
Yeah. Thanks for coming, everybody. And what an awesome 4 years of Genshin Impact.
So much happened.
Yeah.
We've got some surprises in store, so
I like how that's just how they left it off.
Other Teyvat Talks.
Teyvat Talks. Talks.
Stay tuned.
Talks.
All right?
Stay tuned, guys. So no Farina? Yeah, I know. It's okay. Oh.
Yes!
Welcome to VAT Talks. I'm Sarah Miller, creator and the voice of Lumine. And joining me are my lovely co-hosts, Crystal and Jenny.
Hi, everybody. Crystal Lee here.
All the girlies.
The legendary champion duelist herself, Pew Pew.
Hello, it is me. I have returned. It is Jenny Okobori. I am the voice of Yoimiya. And I hope
all my favorite girlies.
Sparks joy with all of you out there.
I see what you did funny. There.
Speaking of the anniversary, how are you two celebrating this amazing milestone?
Oh, one heck of a milestone. 4 years? That's like enough to get a bachelor's degree. I mean, I'm going to celebrate my graduation from Genshin Impact University. That's what I'm doing.
I'm graduating from Genshin Impact University.
That's amazing.
I am not graduating with honors.
Yet. But I'm sure I'll play more Genshin Impact as usual. Come on, you've been in this game since the beginning.
You should see your twin, Sarah.
Nothing? No, listen. I've been looking for him for 4 long years, okay?
I'd buy a graduation cap.
Crystal, you mentioned that you're going to graduate. I think I'm going to enroll in grad school so I can stay here for as long as I can.
Yes.
I'm enjoying
my
time.
Because that's the best move. Get that PhD. Yeah. I'll get that postdoc.
I am very much a person that is motivated by sweet little treat culture, and so I just want to know when my next sweet little treat's going to be. And
I think
I want to indulge in a cake. I want to get one of the Genshin Impact birthday cakes that they send you on your birthday. It's 4 years of looking at them.
Me getting a cake for Shaonito's birthday.
Anyway,
and I got a Yoimiya cake. I forgot.
Have to say about this momentous occasion.
I forgot about that.
Happy anniversary, Genshin Impact!
I'm so
humbled to be part of such a vast world and talented cast. When I auditioned for Chiori, I felt such a connection to her inner strength as a fellow AFAB business owner who is often told they are intimidating, who was discouraged at the beginning of their career, and who has big aspirations. Throughout the recording, Chiori has continued to inspire me through her bold and individualistic style, and I hope to have brought a bit of me to you all through her.
Thank you, Chiori.
That is so sweet.
What was her name? Brittany?
Wait,
thank you, Brittany.
I love that.
I love Brittany.
Oh my god, can they bring Shanyun's voice actress back up?
I really love how...
That's my best friend. She rated me once, so we're besties.
Strong women, you know? Like, a business owner as, like, being one of such example. That's amazing.
Where's Corey?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. Oh my gosh.
Where's the best voice actor, Corey Yee?
Do feel such connections.
Give him to me right now.
Partially.
Where is he?
What I think, you know, like, helps us...
really connect,
bring them to life. You know what I mean?
Wait, I'm surprised they're not doing Sino's
voice
actor.
I mean, because I also have a twin brother in real life.
Yes.
Well, that's funny.
Yeah,
so what are the odds of that?
One of the reasons that recording for the We Are Reunited quest is like so special and emotional for me. Honestly, I've gotten teary-eyed basically every single time we've recorded Ether and Lumine getting to be together again because I really cannot imagine how horrible.
Well, she must have been a mess during Shanyun's story quest.
Just, like, ooh. Makes me so emotional.
Oh, no.
I would have been sobbing. I was sobbing. Wait, I did cry. I forgot.
Giving me direction for the opening cutscene where they get separated. It actually made me cry.
Oh.
The end.
I love to laugh, if you can tell. And I love to laugh as Farina, especially.
Here she is, our girl.
Some of my favorite booth moments involve doing her variety of
She
laughs.
Does such a good crazy laugh.
I also kept cracking up later on when she's directing and shouts, action! I had so much fun doing those in a variety of ways. And I'm so, so happy the team liked the variety and even some of the sillier ones. You know the ones. On the other side of the spectrum,
I keep hiccuping.
One of my favorite scenes I got to do was when Farina was on stage, reliving all those different moments from her past up to the current day. I'm not joking when I say I couldn't stop crying in the booth while recording those. Legit. Tears for days.
I cried as well playing.
Oh. That's a lot of tears today. That's a lot
Oh my gosh. I know. I guess everyone's talking about things that made them emotional.
Right. Gosh.
I'm just like, I'm going to keep saying this because I love so much of our cast, but I'm like, I love Amber. And
yes.
She's also,
amazing.
Like, it's very true. Like, she does love to laugh. She's a close friend
I don't think
of mine,
they're going to put Tainari's voice actor on here, guys.
I feel like Farina
Remember?
Was just made for her.
Right, and it's like the way that a lot of people match up with their characters and relate so well, it's one of the most incredible things. And like seriously, Farina has some of the cutest laughs
yes!
ever.
Absolutely.
Maybe Sino. Yeah. He's super active.
Oh my gosh. Well, okay. I mean, back to the question though. What about you, Jenny?
Okay, so, I mean, my first job when I moved out to LA was actually being a pyrotechnician.
Wait, no way. Are you serious?
That's amazing.
What?
What are the odds of that? That's so funny.
Fully intended, by the way, huh. at that job. And it really helped shape who I am. And I honestly feel like Yoimi and I were kind of meant for each other.
Oh,
it definitely feels like fate. Our similarities even, like, go beyond working with fireworks, too. Yoimi and I are extremely bubbly and very talkative, as you guys have probably picked up on by now.
No, yeah, but there was, like, an issue with the new voice actor as well.
However, I think the most meaningful similarity is the love we both feel for our disabled fathers. My father has since passed, but I grew up as the primary caretaker for my father, who had Alzheimer's. So seeing Yoimi interact and help her father really struck a chord with me.
Wait, that's so special for her.
I love her so much.
What are the odds of that? That she got a character that related to her in like such unique ways. That's really interesting.
Like, present company included, because of this opportunity that I've gotten to voice her, including her Japanese voice actor, who I got to meet last year, and she was so lovely.
Oh, that's cute. They got to meet up. I didn't know that.
I've seen so much of the world through conventions. Yeah. It's such an unbelievable honor to lend my voice to Yoimiya, who's a character that just brings joy to so many people all over the world.
You do such a beautiful job of it too.
That is true. Yoimiya is the cutie patootiest.
When I was cast, as
I knew she was
going
to be here.
I'm so excited.
Olé, olá, oh Lord.
Yay. So Feather Vine Leza Fest, Venti keeps talking about how he's rehearsing this big song and that he's going to perform it at the end of the event, and he keeps saying the word song. So when we got to that final performance, I was like, hey, just for funsies, since we're running ahead of schedule, can I do a version where I sing at the end just for fun? And the team was like, sure, if you can come up with a tune really quick, we can do it just for fun. So I went on break for like 5 minutes and came back with a little tune for the lyrics and then recorded it in one take. It was super fun, but I didn't expect them to actually use it in the game because, like I've said 5,000 times, it was just for fun. And so when the event came out and people started excitingly tagging me in posts about Venti singing, I was so shocked and so excited. Oh my gosh. And it was just so sweet to see how much Venti singing meant to the fans. Like the reaction.
She's
so
iconic for that because let me tell you, I will Olé 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 Lord. I know that's not what she's referencing right now, but that little cover she released.
For another event sometime, like,
I was stuck in my head for months.
I'm just really happy that I got to sing.
There will come
so
to
Olé 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 Lord. She just came up with the tune. Like, yes.
Spontaneously, just there, right on the spot.
I love it.
I know. And like, I don't know if y'all have heard the Venti song from that event, but it is so good.
I don't remember that. I know she sang. I don't remember the song.
She's so stinking talented. She really is.
She's so talented.
That's crazy.
I know. Well, okay. So we've been hearing about how all these people feel like a connection.
Knock that off, stink.
And I was wondering, Crystal, if you have an answer to that.
Oh my gosh.
Ooh, juicy.
I mean, yeah, no, I think one of the things that really brought me so close to Clarande was when I found out she was a secret nerd. Like, the second I found out she plays tabletop and like plays tabletop with her friends, like Navia, and I was like, that's crazy, because I walked in and everyone on the call was like, hey, so I don't know if you know about tabletop or like, you know, certain games involving tabletop. And I was like, are you kidding me? I live for that stuff. I love it so much. And so to be able to bring that side to her was just so incredibly fun. And I loved connecting with how much she... like, she's secretly super, super friendly. Like, you don't expect it when you meet her. She's, like, super stoic and, like, down to business. But secretly, she's just out here loving her friends and, like, supporting people. And,
Clarence's a cutie, like a secret cutie pie, you know? She's very sweet, but, like,
she really came alive
on the DL.
I found that
she's
much
cute.
More
I like her.
About her personal life. Beyond
didn't pull for her,
the court. It
but
was
I like
so
her.
Much fun. And
that's so cute.
I love
that.
Her so much. Thank you.
Oh my gosh. Well, it's been so great to hear from all these different actors. I've loved this. This is great.
This is
so really fun.
I know. I love hearing about how everyone connected, like, personally. It's like that little backstage glimpse that you don't usually get.
Yes. A little peek behind the curtain, if you will.
Exactly.
What's wrong?
I still can't believe it's been 4 years.
What happened?
I feel like no time at all has passed.
So many no's.
All the time has passed.
No kabe. Like,
it's so surreal. It really is.
Who knows?
Give us kabe, Hoyo, please.
Well, my gosh. I mean, well, this has been great. I've had so much fun with y'all today.
Same. And I can't wait for the next. So, I mean, hey, everyone, stay tuned for more. And happy anniversary, travelers.
Yes, happy anniversary.
Woo!
Yay. Is that it? Oh, there's more, Darcy.
Hello, everybody. This is Alejandro.
I did call it with a Sino. I knew it.
Thanks for tuning in to Tevet Talks.
Hey everyone, Joe Zija, voice of Risley here, wishing everybody a happy Genshin Impact 4-year anniversary.
Yeah, same. Dude, I can't believe it's been 4 years. Oh my gosh.
You have
one fourth. I remember when the game first started and I was like, I have no idea what I'm doing. And now I'm like, I know a little bit of what I'm doing.
He's so knowledgeable.
Yeah, I don't think I've even reached a little bit. I think like when I stream the game, it's mostly entertaining because I don't know what I'm doing at all. It's been awesome to get to know the fan base and the game, and it's just this Genshin Impact has become this whole massive world. Like, who could have imagined?
Yeah, it's crazy. Yeah, so I totally get it. So, without further delay, let's check out what our voice actors have to say about this landmark occasion in our journey.
Who's it gonna be?
Hey, I'm the English voice of the Knave, aka Arlecchino. Oh, aka Father. We've recorded many Arlecchino scenes over the years that I am really quite fond of, but I think the ones that I recall most
I'm winning so well today.
Moments of vulnerability and chilly tenderness, particularly in those few intimate moments with her children or with Clairvy.
Welcome to Shame, and thank you for the follow. I appreciate it.
Something special while in the booth, but oh boy, watching the finished sequences with all the other actors' performances in there instantly made me so proud to be a part of this cast.
I'm winning.
Yes,
y'all,
it's also quite fun to play her viciously cool and aloof yet badass sides too. So thank you all for letting me be a small piece of this huge adventure. And for being such an incredible and welcoming community. Congrats on 4 amazing years, Genshin. Here's to many more.
Man, Arlecchino is so cool, and I absolutely adored that story.
Yep.
It was dark, and it was just sad at times. But you know, a lot of work goes into building voices for these characters, you know?
Yeah, and sometimes like you don't know what the work's going to be until you get there. One of my favorite lines of Risley's is, if the Duke wants somebody dead, he needs no justification.
And period.
A lot of people don't know that it's one of the first scenes we ever did in the booth. And I remember thinking, like, whoa, this guy's, like, rough. He's a prison warden. He's over here saying he's above the law. Okay, I guess you know, we'll play him tough, right? We'll play him really rough. And then it turned out that he was this really intelligent, respectable, even like kind man. Yeah. And so I just had to take that.
His normal voice sounds very similar to Risley's, though.
And then apply it to his otherwise really formal language. He speaks really intelligently, but he's also got this kind of like blue collar spirit that makes for a super interesting mix. It was just one of those fun experiments in character development on the fly.
Yeah. Moments like that are absolutely awesome, especially when portraying these characters that have so many layers and so many dimensions. I mean, in Sino's second story, we got to see so many layers of Sino.
I loved Sino. Both of Sino's story quests
were so
good.
We're so used to him
good.
Being nice to his friends.
Loved
after
those.
So
those
many
are some good quests that came out.
Impact,
well,
like, he's like, oh,
came
let's
out
play Genius Invocation
year,
TCG. Here's a random joke. But it's cool that we finally got to, you know, a nice reminder that he's still the general Mahamantra.
Yeah, and it, like all of us have our own little stories about how we came to it, and they're all really unique. So let's see how some others spent their time behind the mic for this.
Yeah.
Kave.
First of all, congratulations
okay, she's a cutie.
On 4 years, you cute people. I mean, wow, I have been part of the incredible Genshin Impact universe for almost exactly a year now, and let me just say, I was instantly hooked.
She doesn't.
From the talented team at MiHoYo.
I love Navia's
and our voice
voice.
Directors,
she does an excellent
to the hardworking
job.
Studio crew and the players around the globe. There is such an incredible energy tying us all together. When we started our records and I dove into Navia's emotional roller coaster of a backstory,
she sounds very similar
I knew
as well, yeah.
That this game was something special. I mean, Malus and Silver still make me tear up just thinking about them.
Rest in peace.
Oh man. Silver
shout out Malus and Silver.
I miss those guys. They were so cool. They were funny, but
rest in peace, soldiers.
Man, Good times.
I'll miss you.
Yeah, I can't wait to meet him. I haven't gotten to that part of the game yet, so...
Oh!
Before we get into any spoilers, let's hear from Amber and Stephanie.
Yeah.
No one tell them.
Congratulations on the 4-year anniversary! This year has been the most exciting for me, because I get to be a part of a game that transcends not only story and beauty, but also a great community of players. Emily was such a fun character to play.
Wow, she actually talks like this?
Or terrifying situations, yet gentle when it's called for. She can read the room and sniff problems out pretty quickly, too. I knew she had to be mature enough to have the smarts and kind enough to care for others. Her character impressed me.
Imagine, like, naturally having a voice that cutesy. I cannot relate. I was to play, I feel like I sound like a young man sometimes.
I was on a break.
Her voice is so cute. I'm like shocked.
The main character for this update. Initially, I didn't understand. But then once we recorded more and more, it hit me. I am now part of the Genshin Impact family, which is pretty awesome. It is a true honor. Thank you for having me.
Her voice is, wow.
I still can't believe yes! I've been in the game for nearly 4 years. It's wild to think that I started as Cloudy King of the NPCs.
Love you, Stephanie.
I'm so proud of getting to play her. Not only is she a character. Mother, that
thank you, Stephanie. Stephanie rated me, guys. Me and Stephanie are best friends. She rated me and she was really nice and really sweet.
And so unintentionally hilarious.
And I loved her.
I started playing her as the mysterious and not so kind Adeptus, as we all know.
Mother.
And every time I would return for events, I'd get to give insight into other beloved characters through some pretty funny quips or some deeply sad backstory.
Oh, the tears. I think her quest might have been my favorite from this year.
One was
I also just
moon.
Love the Lantern Knight in general,
I mean,
but I
her
think
human form,
her quest was
I would
excellent.
Be able to share her softer
so good.
Side, the side
so
that
good.
We only had glimpses of. So one was really
yeah. She used to just be a crane, just walking around. You remember
really
from the Leeway story quest?
To play the funny, soft, strong, and intelligent, sassy, and loving character that she is.
She's
I mean,
so good.
She is the type of character I that love has her. Made Genshin Impact so special for so many people throughout the years.
True.
So
one
so
is very pleased. One is.
And happy
one
for
is.
Your anniversary, Genshin Impact.
Thank you, Mother. Love you.
Aw, that man. I'm a nerd for this game. I love
Same.
Genshin Impact, and just hearing so many people and all of the actors in this cast just be so excited about it. I'm not gonna lie, it made me tear up a little, and I know that folks are gonna be like, no, you didn't, and I'm like, man, it just
let
makes
the,
my heart all
let
warm.
Let the man cry. Like,
yeah.
Come on, let him feel.
Yeah.
One of the things,
let
like,
him
the through line
up.
Here for me is how we have this thing called Genshin Impact, or any story, really, mm-hmm. and all we're hearing from actors is that how it evolved, right? Like, no one knows what shape it's going to take. You just release this thing into the world, and then the collaborative efforts of all these people kind of morph and change, and it's yeah. developed so organically. It's really, really cool, like a living, breathing organism, but it's just art.
Yeah. And I'm just so honored that I get to be a part of this, of the English
no,
cast.
No, I hate them
and
no, Kaveh, so Darcy's not yeah. doing too well, Aura.
Well, everyone, that's a wrap on Teyvat Talks. Thanks for tuning in.
These 4 years of
Thank
Genshin Impact
us.
Have been amazing, and the adventure continues on.
Darcy is not coping well. Is that it? Oh. Quite the end. Oh, excuse me. Quite the ending. No! Where's Kaveh? Darcy. I got you, Darcy. Oh, that was crazy. All right. Well, it has officially been 2 hours. Oh my God. I need to go to bed. I have work in the morning. But lots of exciting stuff, lots of exciting changes. So many quality of life updates. I cannot believe how many quality of life updates we have. I know. I'll claim my commissions. I won't forget. Thank you for reminding me, though. I'll watch it. Darcy, I need to go to bed. I'll watch it tomorrow. I'll watch it on Sunday. I don't even care. I don't care.
Why would they release that on the same day as this? Are you trying to stress me out? Yes, I didn't even know someone redeemed a character review, so oops. But anyways, I have to wrap this up because this is the ending for YouTube. Guys, thank you so much for watching. Let me know what you think. Please leave many, many comments. Let me know what you're thinking, what you're excited for, what your favorite part was. Let me know what you think of the music, because I think it's peak. It sounds so good already. But the 50-50 stuff was... Oh, anyways, I'll explain that later. But I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.